talked about of my thesis entitled Pharmaceutical Degradation in Hospital Waste Water by Building Advanced in Oxidation Processes, an Approach to the Use of Sunlight. This thesis was oriented by the Dr. Carla Sirtori and Dr. Elaine Regina López-Sivos. To start, I would like to share this picture. It is a representation of environmental contamination with focus in the water pollution and the presence of pharmaceutical in water, sorry. And according with the different studies, the water pollution killed more than 1.8 million of people around the world. And nowadays, the situation is not better because the population are consuming more personal care products and pharmaceutical by the COVID-19. And so this is a worried situation right now. So in this case, how can we solve it? Throughout this presentation, I'm going to talk about different alternatives to the treatment in the degradation of the pharmaceutical in water and wastewater. Okay, this presentation will cover five big topics. The first one is the introduction about the pharmaceutical and advanced oxidation processes, followed by one objective followed by the objectives and one overview about the methodology. Then I will present some results and conclusion of the different works. Most of them were done in the home institution, but also we established collaboration with the University of Porto with the Dr. Victor Villar Research Group and the University of Manitoba with the Dr. Kijuan Research Group. Finally, I will present the conclusion and last but not least, the acknowledgement. Okay, so the emerging pollutants is a group of the different substances that we use in our everyday, for example, the personal care products, the pharmaceutical, endocrine disruptor drugs, pesticides. They are not yet regulated and they get into our environment in low concentrations, nanograms per liter, micrograms per liter. Although they are in low concentration, they can affect the water quality, the drinking water supply, the ecosystem balance, and the human health. The question in this part is, what are they in our environment? Like I said before, they're confluent of the different activities in our everyday, and they end up in the wastewater and the wastewater treatment plant. But this wastewater treatment plant use biological processes, and in some cases, these biological processes are effective to the pharmaceutical degradation or the emerging pollutants degradation. But what happened in Brazil, according to the National Sanitation System in 2017, Brazil only recollect the 46% of the wastewater is collected, but a small part of it is treated through conventional processes. It means that more than 50% of the wastewater generated in Brazil are put into directly in our environment. According to the international levels, the European Commission proposed the setting of environmental quality standards for some pharmaceuticals of emerging concern. And this same commission proposed one watch list that it's composed for other pharmaceuticals, and we don't have enough information about it. For this reason, it's important continue to study of the effect of this pharmaceutical in our environment. Okay, so the focus or the objective of this work was the pharmaceutical degradation in hospital wastewater. Consider this hospital wastewater one hot spot. Well, what treatments can be used? One alternative is advanced oxidation processes. Advanced oxidation processes will be classified according with the reactive phase, homogeneous or heterogeneous, or according with the radical generation methods. So in this presentation, I'm going to talk about the solar phenton, the phenton process, and the heterogeneous prototypes. The phenton reaction was discovered by Henry Phenton in 1894, and he reported that hydrogen peroxide could be activated by ferrous ion to produce hydroxyl radicals. These species of this hydroxyl radical could react with the organic molecules and degrade these organic molecules. And at the same time, with presence of the more oxidant regions, we can produce more oxidant species. This reaction of this process in contact with the irradiation accelerate this reaction number two, And this is more faster in comparison with the dark phantom. This process is called photophantom, but when we use the solar radiation, this process is called solar photophantom. The important parameters in this part is the pH, the concentration of iron, the kinds of iron, and the concentration of hydrogen peroxide. The best performance of the phenton and photophenton process is in the acid pH, because in this range of pH we can or keeping the iron in solution and maintain the aqueous complex of iron present high solubility, and some of them present for activity in the solar spectrum. So for this reason, it's one alternative, use the solar irradiation in photophenton processes. But should we acidify the wastewater? All depend on characteristics of our wastewater. For example, in the specific case of the hospital wastewater, the pH is around the 8. And when this hospital wastewater present inorganic carbon, high inorganic carbon, it produce one buffer solution. So I need high quantities or large quantities of acid solution to decrease the pH, and high quantities of basic solution to the neutralization phase. It produces one negative impact to the environment, increase of the salinity, and the cost of the process. Can we work at pH neutrality? Yeah, it's possible work at pH neutrality when we use with chelating agents, for example, oxalate, EDDs, humic substance, and these chelating agents complex the iron and keeping the iron, maintain the iron in solution and maintain the activity in the UV spectrum and produce radical oxygen species. Other alternative is the heterogeneous photocatalysis. In this case, we use one semiconductor with characteristics in UV irradiation or solar irradiation. And the first step is to create the electron hole pairs. And these electron hole pairs take reaction, take place in different redox reactions to produce radical oxygen species. Other alternative is to use oxidant reagents, for example, hydrogen peroxide and persulfate, to produce more radical oxygen species, and to decrease the recombination of the electron hole pair. Okay, and about the evaluation. Normally, the evaluation in the wastewater treatment is by the percentage of mineralization, but in some cases, or the most part of the case, our pollutant is not completely mineralized, and even after our parent compounds are fully degraded, it's create throughout the process different transformation products, and some of them, these transformation products present characteristics of a high toxicity in comparison with the parent compounds. For this reason, it's important to study the transformation products. In our research group, we use the database of transformation products to identify these transformation products that are generated throughout the process. And this database of transformation products is constantly updating with information from the different articles and with information produced in our research group. And this the advantage is the automatization of the obtained the data. Also, relating this information of transformation products, we can relate with the biological tests. But what happens if we don't have, or our laboratory don't have, the toxicity test protocols or the toxicity test, the toxicity equipment? One alternative is the use of the QSAR models. These QSAR models are different software that present a different database about the toxicity with one group of the molecules. So in this case, the software relates my information, my molecular structure information of my transformation products, relates with the database at the software, and give me some prediction about the toxicity. Okay, so consider this scenario. The main objective of this PhD thesis is to evaluate the different advanced oxidation processes in which close to neutrality for the degradation of pharmaceutical in different water matrices with emphasis in hospital wastewater. This is the main objective. We establish also specific objectives regarding to advanced oxidation processes, analytical tools, and user models. According to the advanced oxidation processes, the characterization of the hospital wastewater by some macroparameters, the optimization of the and study of pharmaceutical degradation in different matrices using one batch reactor with capacity of 1 liter, and the scale up of the process to the best performance in the previous step. And this was by the construction and use of the low-cost raceway pond reactor. According to analytical tools, it is develop and validate analytical methods to control the main parameters such as iron and hydrogen peroxide concentration, the develop of the analytical methodology based in the liquid chromatography for the confirmation and quantification of pharmaceuticals in different matrices, the elaboration and application of the database of transformation products, and understand how the degradation or the mechanism of degradation that take place through the oxidative species. And about the user models, they predict these transformation products relate the information of these transformation products with the toxicity and biodegradability with in silico QSAR tools to identify the possible impact on the environment and the human health. Okay, so let's go to methodology. We work with a mix of pharmaceutical, and this mix is a different kinds of pharmaceutical with different therapeutic classes. We have the psychiatric, analgesic, diuretic, anti-inflammatory, hormone, beta-blocker, lipid regulator. And our work solution in most part of the case was the 500 micrograms per liter, but also we work with the 200 micrograms per liter and 50 micrograms per liter of each pharmaceutical. We work with the different matrices. We work in distillate weather, similar with weather, and real hospital with weather. Focusing the real hospital with weather, this sample of the process were done in the local hospital in Porto Alegre City. And this project was approved by the ethics committee at the university and the hospital. Okay, this thesis, or in this thesis, we use the three different reactors, the batch reactor with capacity of 1 liter, raceway ponds with capacity of 10 liters, and tubing to membrane reactor with capacity of 6 liters. This reactor is continuous. And the batch reactor and the raceway ponds we use in the solar experiments, and the solar experiments were carried out in the Universidad Federal de Rio Grande do Sul. And the characteristics of the weather was the sunny days and clean skies. And the parameters or the monitoring of the parameters was about the totalities of iron, the hydrogen peroxide consumption, in some cases, dissolved organic carbon, and the quantification of pharmaceutical by liquid chromatography, and the identification of the transformation products using the database of transformation products. The solar experiment, we use the T30W, that the T30W is the T30W is the normalization of the reaction, the normal time with the irradiation that fall upon in the reactor. It allow us to compare the different experiments in different days. And the tubing tube membrane reactor works with UV lamps. Okay, according with the QSAR tools, we use 4 software, and according to this software, we can use different models that present endpoints according to biodegradability, rate of reaction, oral toxicity, mutagenicity, bioconcentration, and between others. According with the results and conclusions in reasons and discussions, in this part, the first word that we study was about the classical phenton or the phenton, dark phenton. The word of the aim of this word was to optimize experimental conditions using a phenton process using Dolger designs and evaluate the influence of the three different matrices. The Silas weather, similar was weather, and Royal Hospital was weather, and apply our database of transformation products. Okay, so in this case, we apply one Doyle design with three variables, the concentration of iron, the concentration of hydrogen peroxide, and the pH level. And according with these metrics, we carry out, we perform 16 experiments, and the experiments number three give us the best percentage of mineralization after the 60 minutes. With all data obtained for these Doyle designs, we design the surface model, response surface model, to visualize the model, and the condition of the test number three we apply for the next step. So with this, we apply this condition in the distillate weather, simulated weather, and the hospital weather. You can see that when increase the complexity of the matrix, decrease the percentage of the degradation, increase the percentage of the mineralization. So in this case, we use thinking in the real hospital with weather, other strategy, we use other strategy that was the use of the successive addition of iron in the first minutes of the reaction. With this, we increase quantity of the iron, but maintain the concentration of hydrogen peroxide at the same pH. So with this, increase the percentage of degradation in all matrices, and the percentage of mineralization in the distillate water increasing 40%, and in similar with weather and real hospital with weather increase in around 15%. Okay, and according with the behavior of the data, we can't explain this behavior in pseudo second order or pseudo first order. So for this reason, we use one model by the Shannon Shu. This is a model for the kinetics reaction. When in this case, we have one fast degradation in the first step of the process, followed by one slow degradation at the final of the process. So all data obtained according with the Doyle designs, all data obtained according with the degradation of in our matrices was applied with this model, present one percentage of a determination coefficient of above 0.99. And it can identify 12 transformation products, most of them with characteristics of high oral toxicity according to the Kramer rules. And some of them present characteristics of biodegradability. The highlights of this first work and the advantage is that we explore the optimization of condition in phenton process. Explore also the successive addition of iron through a strategy to improve the percentage of mineralization. This work was the first work that we use the database of transformation products. And in this part, I would like to recognize the hard work of my advisor, of course, and the different colleagues in my research group. The drawback. The excess of the reagents, that it implies the cost of the process and one negative impact on the environment. Okay, so in this part, we start with the solar experiment. The first word was about one modification of alginate spheres, the alginate is one biopolymer, and the immobilization of iron in these alginate spheres has a strategy to iron dosage in the three different matrices, and also we analyze the transformation products. In the first step, we carried out the spheres, and in this case, we have the iron 3 alginate, the iron 2 alginate. Also, we use the mining waste For the properties, the magnetic properties to the spheres, and fortifications mining ways with iron 2 and iron 3. And we apply one solar for Fenton process using 3 grams of the spheres, 25 milligram per liter of hydrogen peroxide at pH 5. According to three reuse times, the material that present a best percentage of degradation was iron 3 alginate, because I can degrade all pharmaceutical in the three reuse times. And but it's important in this part take account that when we use these spheres contain iron and alginate, it's possible the synergy effect, because it's possible one adsorption of the pharmaceutical into the sphere. It's possible these spheres are continuously release iron to solution, so it's possible one homogeneous processes. And also the iron present in the surface is possible one heterogeneous processes. So to confirm a little more this synergy process, we compare the homo-heterogeneous process, that is the process using this sphere, with one homogeneous process using one sequential addition. And we simulate in this case the iron concentration that is released by the sphere into the solution. And according to the results, we can achieve high percentage of degradation in this part, but if we compare the both experiments in the experiment contained of homo heterogeneous process contained the sphere, we can achieve best percentage of degradation in this short time. So it confirmed that it's possible. Yeah, it's of course we can have one synergic effect when we use the spheres. And in the other step of this research, we apply these spheres, the iron 3 alginate, in simulate waste weather and real hospital waste weather. But in this case, we have one high organic load, so we need more quantities of hydrogen peroxide. And these quantities of hydrogen peroxide, we use one strategy of successive additions of hydrogen peroxide in different times of the reaction. In reaction time of 3 hours, we achieve a percentage of degradation about 80% in the real hospital waste water with total consumption of hydrogen peroxide. So we identified in this part 19 transformation products. Most of them present oral toxicity, high oral toxicity according with the Kramer rules, and only two transformation products present characteristics of biodegradability. The other were recalcitrant. And the highlights, the advantage is we explore in this work the strategy of the iron dosage using one biopolymer, and also study a little more the synergic effect between homo and heterogeneous processes. We reduce the concentration of hydrogen peroxide if we compare this the initial concentration using the dark Fenton, so we can reduce the concentration of hydrogen peroxide. But the drawback, the iron lixiviation into the solution, the iron release into the solution, because it's a this concentration of iron was below to 15 milligram per liter, that is permissible by the Brazilian legislation, but it's considered high concentration of iron into the solution at the final of the time. Also high organic load, because the hydrogen peroxide also reacts with the biopolymer, with the alginate, and the a few reuse times, because it's normal and one reuse times of 5 or more times. Okay, and in this part we study the complex, the formation of the complex of iron and EDES, that EDES is this one chelating agent. And in this part, the goal of this paper was define the optimal conditions using this complex and the study of transformation products, of course. In the first step, we use the circle voltammetry to the characterization of my complex. And according with the analysis, we can determine that the ratio between iron and EBBAs is 1:1:2. And in this ratio, the complex presents one stability from 3 to 9. And with presence of the solar irradiation and the present with the simulated waste weather, this complex is a stable until it's 7 for 2 hours of the reaction, or 2 hours in contact with the irradiation. So with this data, we apply Wandoller design to identify the best condition of hydrogen peroxide concentration and the complex concentration with the ratio 1:2 iron EDTS. With this, we perform 9 experiments on the replicate experiment 7, 8, and 9 present a high percentage of the decrease in the distillate weather and simulated waste weather. With the data, also we visualize the model in the distillate weather and the simulated waste weather by the responsive phase model. And these parameters we apply in the next step. So in the next step, we apply the condition in the distillate weather and simulated waste weather. And in 30 minutes of the reaction, we can achieve one totally degradation, or the pharmaceutical, the concentration of pharmaceutical was below to the limit of detection of our method. And in a simulated waste weather, in the final time, the most persistent pharmaceuticals were the propanolol, diazepam, and progesterone. And these present one concentration below to the limit of quantification of our method. And according to the transformation products, these transformation products were generated at the initial step of the process. And throughout the process, these transformation products were degraded. The final transformation products of the transformation products remained at the final of the process present characteristics of more biodegradability and low toxicity. The highlights in this study, the advantage, one fast degradation of pharmaceutical and also the transformation products, but the drawback is the hydrocyanic load produced by the use of the EDTs, in this case is 1:1:2 of 1:2 of EDTs. And this EDTs, the cost of the elating agent, because it's expensive. And on the other hand, we use the zero-valent scrap iron. The zero-valent scrap iron is one waste from metal industry. And the goal of this work was to evaluate the pharmaceutical degradation in the real hospital with weather using also QSAR predictions. In the previous step, we established that the optimal pH for this kind of the of catalyst was the acid pH, pH 3, and we used the Doherty signs to identify which is the concentration, which are the concentration of hydrogen peroxide and zero valent scrap iron, the quantity of zero valent scrap iron. But for this reason, we use also the desirability profile to visualize the behavior or the profile of the hydrogen peroxide and the zero valent scrap iron. With this, the concentration of hydrogen peroxide was around the 61 milligrams per liter and 2 grams of the zero valent scrap iron. This condition we apply in the different matrices. In all matrices, we achieve one percentage of degradation around above 90%. And in real hospital with weather, we study to a strategy of iron dosage, the unique addition of hydrogen peroxide, and the successive addition of hydrogen peroxide. The successive addition of hydrogen peroxide were slightly better in comparison with the unique addition of hydrogen peroxide. And according with the transformation products, the most part of the transformation products were produced in the initial step of the process. By relating this information with the QSAR tools, we can identify that these transformation products present higher toxicity. It means that the transformation products present higher toxicity than our parent compound. So, but in the initial step of the process, or the process of our at the final step, the toxicity of these transformation products decrease, or the transformation products were completely degraded in the process. And the highlights, the advantage, the use of the waste, the metal waste from the industry, the degradation of pharmaceutical and transformation products, but the drawback is the high quantity or high concentration of iron release solution and the acid pH. Okay, and in this part, this part is the scale up of the process. So according with the previous results, we determined that the iron 3DDs was the best experiment to achieve a high percentage of degradation in the complex matrices in the real hospital waste paper. And in this case, this work, the aim was the study disability of the complex, but in this kind of the reactor. So for this, in the first step, we study 500 micrograms per liter of the pharmaceutical compared to ratio of the iron 3DDs, ratio 1 to 1 and ratio 1 to 2. We can see that the ratio 1 to 2 present the best percentage of degradation of our pharmaceutical, but this concentration of 500 micrograms per liter is higher in comparison with the real concentration that we can find in the real hospital waste water. So for this reason, we carried out other experiments using 50 micrograms per liter. But since we use 50 micrograms per liter, we reduce the concentration of the iron and the concentration of the hydrogen peroxide. The iron we use 5 milligrams per liter, and the concentration of hydrogen peroxide we use 50 micrograms per liter, and we reduce all of course the ratio between iron and EDDs because these represent of course of the process. The results wasn't not satisfactory or was not improved in comparison with the obtained with the high quantities of the reagent. But it's possible when we increase the hydrogen peroxide concentration, we can achieve this percentage of degradation in this part. But with comparing the ratio using 500 micrograms per liter, the ratio 1 to 2, 1 to 2, and 1 to 1, we can see that the different advance in oxidation, the different transformation products, sorry, the different transformation products in this ratio, we can, some of them we can degrade in the first step of the process. And in comparison with the iron 3DDs ratio 1 to 1, most part of these transformation products are remained at the final of the process. But okay, this we analyze, we identify 21 transformation products, we analyze with the QSAR tools. But the question in this part was, okay, but what happened? We have a lot of information, but it's possible find some similarities between the different transformation products according to QSAR tools. So to answer this question, we used one clustering analysis, and in this clustering analysis, we find a different or two big groups. And this, for example, this red group was composed by the transformation products from propranolol, paracetamol, and some transformation products from diketone. And these transformation products in the structure present similarities because these transformation products present the opening, ring opening, and the constantly hydroxylation of the mainly moiety. So when we analyze the principal component analysis, the principal component one and principal component two, with this graph, we represent 80% of the variance. So we can explain the variance in 80%. And the variables represent more significance, where the bioaccumulation, biodegradability, and the oral toxicity. And the highlights, the advantage, the study of the transformation products in different ratios of iron and EDDS, and the study of the our resource and user tools by a principal component analysis. The drawback is it's important in this part and the, for future studies, the optimization when we use the optimization of condition, when we use low concentration of pharmaceutical or emerging pollutants and low concentration of the reagents. Okay, and in this part we will I will present the study carried out with the University of Porto with the research group of the Dr. Victor Villar, and it was the work about the new generation of reactors. This is the tube-in-tube membrane reactor. This tube-in-tube membrane reactor, we evaluate the heterogeneous process using hydrogen peroxide and persulfate. And this reactor contained one membrane that carried the oxidant, and this allowed the constantly titration on the reaction time. In this reaction time, we have the pharmaceuticals, and also this reaction time, this reaction zone, contact with the UV irradiation. Other modification of this reactor is the immobilization of titanium dioxide in the membrane and produce more radical oxygen species and produce more emerging pollutants degradation. So in the initial step, in the first work, we evaluate the impact of the use of the membrane with titanium dioxide and without titanium dioxide. In different doses of the hydrogen peroxide. So with this, the percentage of degradation using titanium dioxide increasing 10% in comparison with the system that don't have the titanium dioxide in the membrane. But it's important in this case, when we compare the results with the use the persulfate, this in the system use persulfate, the paracetamol, that is one pharmaceutical in our mix, present a higher percentage of degradation in comparison with the hydrogen peroxide, and the other pharmaceutical present the same percentage of degradation independent of the oxidant employed. But one important thing in this part is analyze how react the radical oxygen species with the pharmaceutical. And for example, when we use the hydrogen peroxide, the main species in the reaction is hydroxyl radical. And this hydroxyl radical could produce one hydroxylation, the direct hydroxylation in the pharmaceutical, or one hydrogen abstraction. Unlike when we use a persulfate, when the more predominant species, the sulfate radicals, the sulfate radicals react more with the electron transfer. So it produces one adduct, and this adduct react with the water in the system or react with the oxygen in the system to produce the hydroxylated transformation product. I had the opportunity also to collaborate with the undergraduate students and their projects, and with Bruna, we validate the use of Photometrics Pro, that is one free application developed by the Brazilian universities. And we analyze the determination of iron and hydrogen peroxide with focus in the solar propentio experiments. And another hand with Calita and Leo, we study the degradation of pharmaceutical using one photocatalyst prepared from the petrochemical waste. We study the percentage of degradation and also the transformation products. And conclusions. Okay, according with the efficiency of the process, the solar process presents advantage in relation with the traditional Fenton processes. But in related with the transformation products, how the transformation products generate and the transformation products that could be degraded in the system, the iron 3DDS and the serum valine scrap iron present a best performance in this case. But, or however, the DDS present one disadvantage, that is the cost of the chelating agent, and the serum valine scrap iron present a disadvantage in regarding to the environmental impact by the acid conditions. And when we compare with the tube-in-tube membrane reactor, we can compare because it are different reactors, but it's important highlight in this part that we achieve percentage of degradation around the 50% with this reactor in 5 seconds of the reaction. So if we increase the length of the membrane and increase the fluency of the lamps, it's possible to achieve higher percentage of degradation in the continuous mode. So this, for this reason, it's important to continue to the study of the kind of this kind of reactors. And according with the mechanism, according to the pathways, we found different mechanism. But for example, in this case, the dipyridon present in most part of the case one reaction in this pyrazolinone ring, and the breakdown of this bond and constantly hydroxylation of this moiety. The same or the diazepam present also the constant hydroxylation in the benzodiazepine ring with the breakdown or this carbon nitrogen bond and constant hydroxylation, and with the propanolol paracetamol fluoxetine is the hydroxylation, the aromatic moiety, and in specific with propanolol, the breakdown of the carbon-oxygen bond and constantly hydroxylation of the aliphatic moiety. And with progesterone, the hydrogen abstraction in this part of the molecule and the hydroxylation in this part of the molecule. But it's important also mention some tips for the future step for the future research regarding to the optimization, because it's important the optimization of the process. But I think that it's necessary to work this optimization with the real matrices and in low concentration of the reagents, the iron or hydrogen peroxide in the case of the Fenton processes, and also in the process is important work with the concentration of pollutants close to the real finding in the wastewater, the different kinds of wastewater. Work in a short time of the reaction, and the toxicity, it's important also we carry out experiments in the laboratory and compare the results with the Q-factors. In my opinion, also this research is important to integrate with the environmental education in all sectors of the society to cause one change in our society. And the acknowledgments, thank you so much to GEMAT, the research group led by the Dr. Carla Sirturi, my advisor and co-advisor, My friends in the different universities, the professor, the financial institution, CAPES, NPK, universidad, the Institute of Chemistry, the hospital in Porto Alegre, my family, and thank you so much.